jange bibaba ba nedezo kwa maganda baki.
Okay, personally I'm very grateful to Google.
I want to thank Google for sponsoring this workshop, for reaching out to us here in Eastern Uganda. Ensuka sabana mbaba belira
nebebonye bisibu. In this hardware session, our interest is basically to introduce participants to the basics of computer hardware. We want to introduce participants to understand how computer systems work, the different types of hardware that build up a computer system. At the end of this workshop, participants should be able to differentiate the different components that form up a computer system, trying to identify the basic hardware like the motherboard, the central processing unit, hard disk, main memory, so that when they assemble these computers in their different schools, they are able to show to the students at high school, because we believe that computer science cannot stand without the functionalities of those different computer hardwares. We're going to look at the different input-output devices. We're going to break the hardware into processing units. We're going to look at the components that form up the whole system, the system units, the input units, the processing unit, the central processing unit, and so on. We believe that when the participants gain this knowledge, they are able to transform the knowledge to the students that they teach, and students are able to appreciate the knowledge of computing and computational thinking by understanding the foundation of computer hardware, ranging from motherboard to the different smaller units of the system.
Aha! Jaja ngevi baba ba nedezo kwa maganda baki ngo mama wangu.
Nifanye nini nende wapi kuwa wako kusibabu winje mbapo ni.
Today we talk high school teachers through programming with Scratch, and we taught them the basics, the basic components that make up Scratch, the motions, the controls, and then we made them go through projects, come up with projects in groups about Scratch. At first we talked about the basic components that make up Scratch. We did some code lab with them. We took them through how to move things around in Scratch, how to add sprites, and then we made a brain teaser to these teachers who came up with amazing projects for Scratch.
What is Scratch? It's an educational programming language and multimedia authoring tool. It can be used by pupils, students, can be used by teachers, can also be used by parents to guide their kids on how to do some things. So it can be used to create animations and 2D games. And we have seen, we've been using Scratch for some students, and the results that we've got show that people who are using Scratch, I see the kids that are using Scratch, like from 8 years to like 14, have like learned to think more. And
again,
we have created an opening ceremony for football tournament with an artist opening up with the music, and people in the stands get taken up and jump out and come to the field and get involved and do this playing different strokes of music that they had.
For us, we designed children and during physical classes in the playground playing.
Okay. Some children are jumping around,
others are cheering, others are walking around, others are cheering, others are seated.
Okay.
Scratch programming helps teachers teach to young students in high schools basic programming principles and help them adopt programming in an easy and fun way. Imagine a student being able to do programming by creating their own 2D game. These students will be impacted. And they will do more because they are doing something which is fun, something their friends will love, and something their friends will have to use, which I think is a major goal why we went out of our way to teach these high school teachers basic Scratch programming.
In this session, we want to introduce participants to the basics of computer networking. We want to show them how to set up a simple computer network. We want to show them how to terminate the different cables that connect computer networks. Basically, the main objective of this session is to introduce participants to the idea of setting up computer networks so that it can enable them share files in their local area networks and the various schools where they come from for easier lab sessions when it comes to practical computer applications and others. Now, basically, the topics we are going to cover included things like introduction to computer networking, the various types of computer networks, including the star, topologies, the LAN, wide area network, and others. So the topics participants covered in this session, basically, the terminated computer network cables, the crossover cable, the straight through cables, they configured the computers to see that there's communication between one computer to another. And we believe that this session, when they eventually get back to their different schools, they'll be able to put this knowledge that they have covered from this networking and eventually develop computer networks in their various schools so that it enables them to share files. They don't need to install applications from one computer to another. So the teachers tested, terminated various cables, straight through cables, crossover cable, tested them using the cable testers and realized that their cable termination was actually working. After that, they connected various computers together, configured them, and saw that there was communication between one computer and the other. And also we introduced them to basic applications that enable them to model computer networks like Packet Tracer, where they design different computer models, different network models, and the different computer network topologies like the star, bus, ring, tested them and saw how packets were flowing between one computer and the other. And we believe that to the sponsors of this program, this has really been a success because this was a big gap in most of the schools that participated in this workshop. Most of them told us that they never had computer networks. They feared to even know, they didn't even know what computer networks were, but they were able this time to realize practically how to design a computer network, how to see packets flowing within one computer and the other, and also how to share files from one computer and the other.
We helped them to go through some of the Google apps for education. We took them through Google Hangouts, we took them through Google Calendars and how they work, how they can schedule some of the meetings they have between them and their students. We also talked to them about the Gmails and how to connect them.
I have been exposed to hands-on activities on the computer hardware, especially the motherboard, which I had a lot of mystery about it. But right now I am confident to examine a motherboard and possibly I can be able to identify some errors. also hands-on activities on the networking computers, that is terminating cables. I thought it was a difficult thing, but at least I can now go and do that. I'll be able to make now networks for my school. I have also learned something about Google Drive. I can now store my save my information without necessarily having to move with a flash disk. And now I'm not afraid with that inconvenience of viruses. Then also I have been exposed to Scratch, that is the software that enables us to make animations. So I think I can build on that and I'll be able to develop some good tutorials about that. And you know, I've also learned something major about network topologies. And I have actually been able to learn how to develop, to install a cheap topology. And I can now be able to really know the cheapest thing to do around in order to have a computer network. Okay, personally, I'm very grateful to Google.
I want to thank Google for sponsoring this workshop, for reaching out to us here in Eastern Uganda. We really appreciate your effort. Thank you very much. Asante, asante, asante. Uwebale, uwebale, uwebale. Asante, uwebale, uwebale, uwebale. Thank you, thank you. Asante, 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 uwebale, uwebale.